إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us some of the stories of his prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام to gain the benefits from them and to know what happened before our prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and not to follow the way of the kuffar, the disbelievers, who lost their dunya and also they lost their akhirah. One of the prophets mentioned in the Quran in more than one surah, Shuaib alayhi salatu wassalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran in surah Al-A'raf and also in surah Hud, wa ila madiyan akhahum Shuaiba, and to the people of Madian we send their brother Shuaib. From his people, he was not a stranger, alayhi salatu wassalam. And Midian, it is north to Medina, a place north to Medina, and also Musa alayhi salatu wassalam went to that place. Wa ila Midian akhahum Shu'aiba. Qala ya qawmi ibudullaha ma lakum min ilahin ghayruh. He said to his people, oh my people, worship Allah, you have no God, no true God other than Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. As all the prophets, alayhim as-salatu wa-salam, said to their people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ وَاجْتَنِبُ الطَّاغُوتِ. So what Shu'aib, alayhi as-salatu wa-salam, said to his people, it was the same. Before him, Nuh, Hud, Salih, and also the prophets after him, until the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the last prophet and messenger. They said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and we certainly sent unto every nation a messenger, saying, worship Allah and avoid the taghut, and avoid the shirk, avoid anyone other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your worship. This is the main thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the messenger for. He said subhanahu wa ta'ala also, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ. And we sent not before you any messenger except we revealed to him that there is no God except me, so worship me. There is no true God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was the same statement from Nuh alayhi salatu wassalam until our messenger Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. Then Shu'aib alayhi salatu wassalam said to his people, قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ بَيِّنَةٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. O my people, worship Allah, you have no deity other than Him. There has come to you clear evidence from your Lord. As all the prophets alayhim as-salatu wassalam, Allah sent all the prophets, all the messengers with clear proofs with him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in the hadith, ma min al-anbiya nabi illa u'tiya ma mithluhu amana alayhi al-bashar. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, every prophet was given miracles, every was given signs because of which people believed. All the messengers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent with them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them what support their da'wah, to let people believe in these prophets and messengers alayhim salatu wassalam. But exactly what every prophet or every messenger sent with what, we don't know all of them, but it was clear for everyone. I mean the people of Shu'aib alayhi salatu wassalam and everyone, he came to them with the clear proofs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Shu'aib alayhi salatu wassalam told them another problem that they are doing. The main problem is shirk billah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After talking about the tawheed, the other things come. About the manners, about the business transaction, and the moral problems Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about Shu'aib. that he said to them, فَأَوْفُ الْكَيْلَ وَالْمِيزَانِ وَلَا تَبْخَسُ النَّاسَ أَشْيَاءَهُمْ. So fulfill the measure and weight, and don't deprive people of their due, and cause not corruption upon the earth after its reformation. There, the people of Shu'aib, people of Midian, number one, they were mushriks. They were not worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Another problem, or next to that, they were cheating people in their business. And subhanAllah, this is one of the major sins. Even if it is little, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ يَسْتَوْفُونَ وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ يُخْسِرُونَ. Woe to those who give less than you. الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ يَسْتَوْفُونَ. Who, when they take a measure from people, take it in full. When they buy, they like to take the whole of their rights, and maybe they like to take more than their rights. But when they sell, they like to cheat people. And the word al-mutaffifin, and there is, you know, a full chapter in the Quran called Surah al-mutaffifin, which means to cheat a very little. Maybe you buy 50 kilos of rice, they give you 49 kilos and 950 grams. They cheat you with 50 grams. They will be in the hellfire because of these 50 grams. This is the meaning of mutaffifin, to cheat a little. And this doesn't mean that if you cheat a lot, this is allowed. It will be worse. So this was one of the problems of people of Shu'aib, Midian. Then he told them, don't walk in corruption on the ground. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, what is the meaning of corruption? It means disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means al-ma'asi, the sins, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Corruption has appeared throughout the land and sea by reason of what the hands of people have earned. Because of the sins, less water we get, I mean less rain. Because of our sins, the grass will be less, the food will be less. Our health, more diseases, strange diseases, new diseases. Because of what? Because of our sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this ayah, لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, may let them taste part of the consequences of what they have done. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not punishing us because of all of our sins. This is part of our sins. This is the consequences of part of our sins. May Allah forgive us. Then Shu'aib said to his people, also this is another problem. وَلَا تَقْعُدُوا بِكُلِّ صِرَاطٍ تُوْعِدُونَ وَتَصُدُّونَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Brothers, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, what people of Shu'aib, what Midian were doing for people, we should avoid that. All of these sins are major sins. We should avoid that. He said subhanahu wa ta'ala about the people of Shu'aib, Midian, and don't sit on every path, threatening and averting from the way of Allah. They were killing people or stealing the money of people, and also averting people from as-sirat al-mustaqim. Don't follow Shu'aib, he's a crazy. Don't follow Shu'aib, he's a magician. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كَذَلِكَ مَا أَتَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا قَالُوا سَاحِرٌ أَوْ مَجْنُونٌ. Like the denial of the people of Mecca. The previous nations denied, no messenger came to them from Allah except that they said regarding him, he is a magician or a madman. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد أما بعد. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the people of Shu'aib, or said to them, Shu'aib told them, وَلَا تَقْعُدُوا بِكُلِّ صِرَاطٍ تُعِدُونَ وَتَصُدُّونَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِهِ تَبْغُونَهَا عِوَجًا. And don't sit on every path, threatening and averting from the way of Allah, those who believe in Him, seeking to make it seem deviant. This is one of the main problems nowadays, and from the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and also before him, showing people that Islam is a bad religion. Islam is a religion not giving the rights for women, for animals, for people. Islam is a religion to kill. Islam is not a religion of peace. Subhanallah. The problem, some Muslims think this is correct. Some Muslims don't read the Quran. Some Muslims don't read the stories of the prophets carefully. We should learn from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us. The time of Nuh, time of Hud, time of Shu'aib. This was very common before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam until now. They were talking bad about Islam. This is one of the tricks of the shaitan al-ins, also shaitan al-jinn. Because they cannot debate Islam. Islam came with the clear proofs, as we mentioned also Shu'aib. Bayinat, clear proofs. And for sure they don't have clear proofs. So what was there? A trick to show that Shu'aib was a crazy. Shu'aib wants to take you from the garden to the hellfire, wal-iyadu billah, and it is the opposite. وَانْضُرُوا كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الْمُفْسِدِينَ Shu'aib, remind them by saying, and remember when you were few and he increased you, and see how was the end of the corruptors. This is also one of the things that, brother, sister, we should remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a lot of favors. So that's why we need and we should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is one of the things that used by Shu'aib alayhi salatu wassalam. He reminded them, your number was very little, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increased you in your number. And also, Shu'aib alayhi salatu wassalam told them, remember people before you. And you know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did with the people before you, people of Hud, and people of Salih, and people of Nuh. And he said, كيف كان عاقبة المفسدين, and see how was the end of the corruptors. So don't repeat the same mistake. And also, this is a message for everyone now. Don't repeat the same way. Don't repeat the same mistake. Don't disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Save yourself. Gain a lot of hasanat by obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers, sisters, inshallah, we'll continue this story next week. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'mineen wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat al ahya' minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qareeb mujib al da'wat ya rabb al alamin. Allahumma ij'al hadha al balad aminan mutma'innan wa sa'ira bilad al muslimin. Allahumma habbib ilayna al iman wa zayyinhu fi qulubina وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق العصيان. اجعلنا اللهم من الراشدين. اللهم ابعد عنا الوباء والبلاء والغلاء يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظ أولادنا. اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا. اللهم تقبل صيامنا. اللهم يسر الحج للمسلمين هذا العام وتقبله منا. اللهم نجي إخوان المسلمين في كل مكان. حر المسجد الأقصى من أيدي يهود. احفظ إخوان المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.